as I see it now, has become more of a lens. Very few individuals are actually practicing Ba Gua. Who is walking the circle for an hour? How many people are walking into schools and just starting to learn a circle form? They're just walking in learning circle forms. They have no noi gong. What is noi gong? Yeah, they all talk about qi gong. What happened to the noi gong? Right? Internal power work.
Where's that?
Right?
The most beautiful thing in this world
is noi gong. Walking the circle properly in a low posture. The middle to lower basin. These are noi gong for an hour. You don't sit up here standing.
Peace. Today, we're going to talk about some of the essentials of walking, sir. Okay? All right, now, let's begin. As you assume your posture, you sit, shift, prefer. Of course, you got that. You can't be all of this. Foot travels flat. Do that by pulling at the hip and the big toe, right? You let the big toe stretch upwards and lead. Then skim across the surface. Step forward. Notice, none of us are machines. Alright, so you're going to get a little of this, depending truly on the flexibility of your ankle. But in lifting and pulling on the toe, traveling, foot drops, suctions, this is where the grip to ground concept comes from. So, shift forward, hips, body, head, everything.
Now see, as I begin, I shift all of my weight forward. Notice how the knee remains over the toe, right? I'm shifting back, keeping the weight well balanced. Everything is even. As I step, I brush my heel, I toe in. Walking an octagon, notice the foot is curved as I walk the perimeter of the circle. I step, brush my toe, place the foot down flat and shift forward. Again, toe in, foot flat, shift the weight. Notice how I'm using the camera as I'm angling how you are actually turning.
Notice now the camera, I'm doing this alone, so I have no one to shoot it with me, so I'm trying my best to angle this out. This right here is to set my line. Right? We're not supposed to rise and fall, bob and weave, and up and down. You're supposed to be running on a smooth plane. Alright? Now, check it out. Notice my relation to my line. It's right in here. Forward, notice where my head is.
You will notice there is no bob or weave. My head is not moving up and down. I am traveling on the same plane, keeping all the principles and all the, how should we say, everything is on point. You push forward, not up to forward, simply forward as the waist leads the way. another example of level walking, stepping in your transition. Notice the scissor legs. The stepping toe in. You see the way the thighs and knees are kept close. Shift forward. The transition of the weight all onto one leg before moving the other leg out as I shift. This is an example that's emphasizing the use of the waist. And remember, in Ba Gua, the waist is what leads. And as it moves on the same plane, notice I'm keeping my alignment, demonstrating, showing you this way. Now from a linear perspective, showing how the alignment remains even when you talk to do the classical guard stance.
The alignment with you, you know what I'm saying? Remember, we're not supposed to be bobbing and weaving, all right? Wherever, whatever plane you're traveling on, you should remain on that plane, right? You should not be going up and under that plane. You should be straight. In combat, it's, how should I say? It looks like you're moving at your opponent straight. It's direct. There is no bob. There is no weave. It's your entire body suddenly moving at them. It makes no sense to them. Okay? As we move forward and the body is remaining on the same plane. Now remember also, we are seeking stillness in motion. Your inside should be completely undisturbed. But again, this is time. This is training. All right? Observe. Remember, in the essence, it's essential that you walk slow. You have to walk slow. All right? Nobody gets this quick. No one. Right? You're not used to walking in a torque to the side like this. No one is. All right? You have to train the body to do it. Initially, you will start off on a 30-degree angle. Some people are literally like here with their body. Okay, ultimately, you should be able to turn at a 90-degree angle. Or, as in some of the classics, some of the old classics, when it said you should walk a tree until the tree is chasing you. That represents, that imagery is all about the looseness of the waist, all right? We see it mostly in the heaven palm. As you turn, you notice you're looking behind you when you're actually doing it right. You're not looking at the palm in front of you. You're looking at the palm behind you. All right? Just to give you an idea, but that's something else. We're concentrating on the walk itself right now. because we've just gone over some of the essentials of the walk. All right? It must be done slow. Now, there are a bunch more that I did not cover, but this is at least a beginning to give you a stable beginning. Okay, and then you work on everything else, and it takes time. Originally, you're supposed to walk the circle for at least 2 years. And that's the Nagong aspect of it. But from just a natural perspective, you have to train and condition the body to be able to do this. The skill of Ba Gua is in the walk. It's in the stepping. That is the first thing that has to be established. Once you understand at least the essentials of the walk, then you start learning the forms. Okay, that's why there are a million drills and so forth for even beginning to walk the circle before you even start the forms. Depending on the style, they go through this. There are a number of drills to open up your waist to help you with your turn and your talking of the upper body and the waist. Alright? The deal is consistency and persistence. Once again, Ba Gua is not user-friendly. It is a highly advanced martial art that develops skill. Now, yes, you get strong, but you need the skill in order to apply the type of strength that is being developed. From there, techniques now become, how should I say, natural and instantaneous. The power you develop from the skill helps you understand the power. You will not understand the power without the skill. And then that means all the rest of all the techniques you're doing are rendered external. Period. Alright? Okay. I'm not going to keep going on this because there's still so much more. Alright, that's it for now. Again, this is Mao Shan. Sifu Ben Obey for Sifu Ben Obey's Ba Gua World. Three Guys in Black. Ba Gua Zhang Research and Boxing Association, the Ba Gua Shing Yi Chan Association. Alright? Until next time, you guys be good. And remember, walk. 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 Peace.